I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept our love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us enter into the presence of God in the silence of our hearts. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who, for the faith they profess or are counted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does His honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go, prophesy to my people Israel.'" The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord himself will give his benefit. Our land shall yield in its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of God's grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him, we have redemption by his blood, the forgiveness of transgressions, in accord with the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us. In all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, in accord with his favor, that he set forth in him as a plan for the fullness of times, to sum up all things in Christ, in heaven and on earth. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to our call. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two, and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a silken tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord. Today, Gospel reading, questions. The question is, how can we find fulfillment, joy, and a sense of vocation in our life? How can we realize what it is to live a life of fullness? Because, brothers and sisters, to live a life of fullness is the process of discerning the deeper question of life, what it is that you are created for, what it is that you are called to be. Today, Jesus identified that mission for the apostles. He called them and sent them out two by two, give them the power over unclean spirit. Think about your life. How do you see your life under this frame of vocation, this light of discernment in your life? Because it makes no mistake, every single decision that you ever make in your life start with a sense of discernment, with a feeling. The person that you met to be married, the career that you choose to live out your life with, the house that you choose to buy, the place that you choose to live, each of those decisions is a calling. Start with a feeling that is depth within your soul. Recalling my own personal journey, started with a feeling that is so deep that I can't really describe. I realized that I want to do something with my life. I want to give my life for something bigger than myself. Being born and raised in Vietnam, and only came to this country when I was 21. All of those experiences taught me something about God's call. Growing up, I always thought that I'm going to become a priest in Vietnam at a parish in my hometown. Little did I know that my discernment led me here in this culture, dealing with the experience of immersions, dealing with the experience of learning and growing in this American culture, and dealing with the tension that comes with it for my own personal culture and with this culture as well. And on top of that, is the experience of the different religious traditions within my family. On my dad's side, we are all fully Catholic. On my mom's side, we are all fully Buddhist and traditional Vietnamese. Growing and discerning a vocation in these circumstances taught me that what it is that God called me is a very, very specific place and times. Think about that in your own life. God called you into a very specific vocation and location in your life. And the moment you realize that is a moment God's grace can help you and teach you. Because that is exactly what the disciple has to deal with. Jesus called them into a very specific circumstances, very specific grace, and very specific action. In order to realize that, here are a couple of suggestions for you. At the very basic foundation is a devotion and a reverence for God. Know who you worship and know who you directed your love and your reverence to. At this holy sacrifice of the Mass, at each and every aspect of your life, know who you worship. The second part is prayer. The commitment to prayer, personal prayer, whatever type of prayer practices that touch you, commit to prayer. The third part is to allow your prayer and your encounter with God to teach you the meaning of the present moment, to allow you to realize that God is calling you each and every moment of your life. And brother and sister, that is what that means to live a life of fulfillment, of happiness. Because fulfillment and happiness is not the absence of struggle, but rather, it's a realization of the fullness of your call, of the fullness of the present moment, of the fullness of the grace of God in your life. Allow Jesus to teach you that. Allow God to open your heart, your mind, your soul through your encounter with Him at the altar, at each and every moment of your life. God will show you the meaning and the power of His grace in your life the moment you allow Him to do it. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death, was buried, rose again the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord Jesus has given us every spiritual blessing in the heavens. With confidence, let us place our trust in him as we give voice to the needs of our hearts.
For the church, may we trust in God's providence as we fulfill our mission to proclaim the good news to the whole world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our legislators, may they work diligently to establish justice and peace for all who dwell in this land. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For missionaries throughout the world, may God bless them with strength and hope as they serve the poorest of the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the victims of the Miami condo collapse, for their families, and for the rescue crews, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the poor, the marginalized, and the outcast, may they find sustenance, acceptance, and welcome. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For St. Norbert Parish, may the members of our community wisely discern their gifts and offer them for the service of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those among us who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, for those listed in the parish bulletin, and especially Bruce Beriducci, Pat Ganzi, Connor Hooven, Rick Earhart, Bertha Chavez, Greg Hahn, Beth Melberger, Stacy Martin, Jaime Gonzalez, Jesus Gregorio. May God comfort them and restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, especially Aniceto Pastrana Nieves, Claude Beardsley, Sam Carbone, Israel Rosas Anaya. May they enjoy forever the fullness of God's grace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the special intention of Jerry Lopez, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. O God, you accomplish all things in accordance with your divine will. Hear the cries of our hearts and give answer to our petitions. For we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Christ before us, Christ beside us, Christ to guide us all our days. He to carry all our sorrows, He to bear us perfect grace. Jesus, Savior, friend and brother, intercessor, Son of God, save your people in your dying and in rising conquer death. May we be for one another all that you would have us be. Love, compassion, charity. May we climb your holy mountain. May we see your holy face. Visit now this dwelling, dwell within this holy place. God, before us through the ages, Christ beside us, here to stay. Spirit, lead us forth forever. Guide and help us all our days. Christ the Savior, God the living, great Creator, Spirit blessed, Holy Three in One, immortal, come and be our welcome guest.
Right, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as he makes a prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they might bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Kevin our Bishop, his brother Bishop Timothy and Thomas, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At a Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis, miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis, miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the nobis pacem, dona nobis pacem.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people. Light for the world to see. Your living voice, Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church. Shine.
bread for others. May we who
Jesus Christ, you call us to your feast, at which the rich and powerful have become the least, where we survive on others in our human greed. You walk among us, begging for your every need. Bread for the world, a world of hunger. Wine for all peoples, people who thirst. May we who eat be bread for others. May we who drink pour out our love.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by all our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
The Spirit sends us for to serve. We go in Jesus' name to bring glad tidings to the poor, God's favor to proclaim. We go to comfort those who mourn and set the burden free. Where hope is dim, to share a dream and help the blind to see. We go to be the hands of Christ, to scatter joy like seed, and all our days to cherish life, to do the loving deed. Then let us go to serve in peace, the gospel to proclaim. God's Spirit has empowered us. We